The concept was that in Mama's Kitchen, it's not what you want, but what you're going to get.
It started out with Lucha Libre, Mexican wrestling, as the influence for the name and the brand and the theme of the restaurant. And Pablo Picante in Spanish means spicy Pablo or spicy Paul. The whole idea being that this wrestler would have a particular personality which was reflected in the food and vice versa. And what better characteristic for a luchador fronting a burrito shop, only that he's quite spicy and quite fiery.
I would say we play blues music. I think compared to some of the places around town, we offer choice. Where you might see we have probably nine choices of hot items and maybe nine choices of cold items. And the amount of combinations you can have amongst that is quite high.
We are very informal. We're very easygoing. We have mixed match furniture. We take names of our customers. We write them on a burrito. This helps us not to confuse them, not to mix them up with somebody else's burrito, and also adds a personal touch.
I wanted Pablo Picante to have that warmth, that real Mexican personality, the colors, the Mexican music, and the Mexican religious icons, the Mexican Lucha Libre symbols. The staff we have are predominantly Mexican, so there's very much a feeling when you come into Pablo Picante, at least there should be, that you're in Little Mexico. There's an element of panini fatigue, as I described it, you know, went around Dublin. It's just paninis were everywhere. You could get them in petrol stations, you could get them in spar shops, they were omnipresent, and there was a need for something new.
The idea of the food, it was fresh food, it was quick, and it was substantial, and it was great value.
Well, it's a new wave, a good meal. Pretty substantial size.
People know that if they have a burrito for their lunch, they will be full until their dinner time. They evolved as Mexican immigrants made their way into North America. The story goes that the burrito was a meal that the immigrants could carry with them. And it was put into a tortilla, the rice, the meat, the beans, the salsa, the cheese, into a tortilla, wrapped up, and they could take it on the go, like a lunchbox, except they could eat the box.
The basic burrito, so it's a flour tortilla with a layer of rice. It's your choice of meat or vegetarian filling, beans, layer of salsa, sour cream, and cheese.
You can add in guacamole, you can add in sour cream, you can add in jalapenos, you can add extra meat, you can add extra vegetables.
And anything that you want to put into a burrito, into a flour wrap, we'll put it into a flour tortilla.
The correct way to eat a burrito is to hold it from top to bottom.
Don't open the whole thing and eat it with a knife and fork.
Sometimes I run over to a person because I see him starting with this burrito and he's got knife and fork and he's going for it, you know, unwrapping the foil.
The important thing is to wind it down gradually as you eat and to keep that foil covering as you work your way down and to keep the integrity of the shape of the burrito.
I think a burrito is meant to be eaten with your hands.
Oh yes, they are healthy and good for you. Full of goodness. All your five a day and more. Male, predominantly, hugely. 18 to 25s, majority of them. Students, a lot of them. Office workers.
Young guys, women. Particularly in this space, we have students, we have suits, I call them workers.
And for the most part, it's young males.
At some point, I even thought maybe I should start a dating agency here. Because it's a single guy, single guy, single guy, single guy, single guy.
In terms of, is Dublin at a saturation point of burrito bars, I'd say yes.
I think burrito bars are here to stay. I think Mexican food is here to stay.
Like with everything else, the weakest will fall, the strongest will stay.